Hi everyone, I welcome you all to the new lecture on 5 problems on series. In today's lecture, we are going to solve 5 problems on single wattmeter method. These are the 5 problems I have taken. The first 2 problems I have taken from the Ravish R. Singh Network Analysis and Synthesis. The third problem from SSGE. The fourth problem, it was repeated in both GATE and IES. The fifth problem I have taken from Engineering Circuit Analysis by William Heath. So let us start with our discussion. So in first problem, what they were asking, they were asking how the reactive power is measured by using the single wattmeter. Okay, so with the help of a single wattmeter itself, we need to measure the reactive power of delivered to the load. So these are the connections which we will make to measure the reactive power. So let us see how clear, clearly see how the reactive power is measured by using the single wattmeter method. Okay, consider. Consider a star connected load to this star connected load I need to measure the reactive power delivered so with the help of a single wattmeter, and these are the connections we will make to measure the reactive power. So what we have done, okay, the current coil of a wattmeter I have connected in series with the R phase. If this is R, Y, B, right? So if the current coil is connected in series with the R phase, and the pressure coil I have connected between the Y and B, right? And what wattmeter will read? Wattmeter reading equal to wattmeter reading will be equal to voltage across the pressure coil into current through the current coil into cos of angle between the pressure coil voltage and current coil current. And what is the where we have connected the pressure coil? The pressure coil is connected between the phase Y and B. So what it will read? V Y B. Okay, the current coil is carrying the current IR, phase current IR. And as it is a star connected load, both phase currents and line currents will be same, right? So I am writing it as IR into cos of angle between V by B and IR. I need to find out the angle between V by B and IR. So for that, let us draw the phasor diagram. Consider for a star connected load, consider this phase voltages, okay. I will denote it with VR, VY, VB, okay. As it is a balanced load, the voltages will be apart with 120 degrees, right. Next, let us draw the phase currents or the line currents, both are same in the star connected load. So this will be my IR current. This will be my IR current, IB, okay. Madam, IR, IY, IB. So the phase angle will be, depending upon the load, phi. Right, now I need to find out the angle between V by B and IR. So here it is V by, okay, so the opposite will be minus IB. I will draw here, see here, sorry, we'll draw with one of them. Okay, right, this will be my minus VB, and the summation of these two vectors will be my v by b. And now see here, so we got v by b vector, right? Next ir vector, right? I need to now find out the angle between these two vectors. Now see here, what will be this angle? See, this will be 180 degrees and this will be 120 degrees. So this angle I will get it as 120 degrees, sorry, 60 degrees, okay, and this will be my 30 degrees, right? This will be my 60 degrees and this will be 30 degrees. Then what is the angle between these two vectors? We know that angle between Vy and Vr is 120 degrees, and if we subtract this 30 degrees, this will be, how much this angle will be? This will be 90 degrees, and we need to find out the angle between Ir and Vyb, okay? This will be 90, okay? This angle I am writing here, 90 minus 5. So what will be the wattmeter reading? Wattmeter reading will be given as Vyb, I am writing it as VL, okay? As it is a line voltage, Ir, I will write it as IL, line current. Why I am writing it as a line current? In star connected load, both line current and phase currents will be same. So I will write it as IL. And now cos of, what is the angle between the two vectors? Already we have derived it, 90 minus 5. So what will be the wattmeter reading at last? It will be VL IL into cos 90 minus 5, it will be sin 5. But how the reactive power, how the wattmeter is reading the reactive power? But for a three phase load, the reactive power Q, reactive power is given as root 3 VL IL into sin phi, right? So which is equal to, I can write it as root 3 into W. So how we are going to find out the reactive power by using a single wattmeter? Just by connecting the current coil in one phase and pressure coil across the remaining two phases, and by multiplying with root 3 factor, okay? Remember this root 3 factor. With the wattmeter reading, it will, you can measure the three phase reactive power delivered to the load, okay? Next, let us see with the second problem. So let us read the question first. Find the reading of the wattmeter when the network shown in the figure is connected to a symmetrical 440 volt three phase supply, right? The phase sequences are R by B, right? So what they were asking, so they have connected the wattmeter in this manner, and they were asking what will be the reading of this wattmeter, right? And solution, see here, solution properly, right? So they had given that the line voltage is 440 volt, okay? So now first, before going entering into the problem, first find out the line voltages, because all these branches are excited with the line voltages, right? Consider this is my Vr, Vy, Vb, okay? I am writing it here, Vr, Vy, Vb, right? Then see here, this will be my minus Vy, okay? This will be my minus Vb, this will be my minus Vr, minus Vr, minus Vb, okay? Then this will be Vyb, okay? V R Y, VBR. Okay, now see the problem, right? So watt meter, where it is connected, the current coil is connected in a R line and the pressure coil is connected between the Y and B. So I will write in here, in this way, see here, watt meter reading equal to voltage across the pressure coil into current through the current coil into cos of angle between the pressure coil voltage and current coil current, right? What is the pressure coil voltage? What, where it is connected? It is connected between, where it is connected? It is connected between the two phases, which is line voltage, right? So what I will get here, I will write it as VYB, and the current coil, where it is connected? The current coil is connected in phase R. So I will write it as IR into cos of angle between VYB and IR. So let us solve one by one. Let us see the VYB. VYB, already we have derived here. Okay, how much it is? 440 at an angle of how much? What is the angle? Minus 90. Okay, and IR, what can I write the value of IR? IR from this apply KCL at this node, and what can we write? IR by minus IBR. So first we need to find out the value of IR by. What is IR by? IR by is the current flowing in this branch. What is the voltage across this branch? VR by. So VR by divided by its impedance ZR by. So how much it is? How much it is? What can I write? 440 at an angle of minus 210. Why? VR by. Where it is VR by? VR by is here, right? Sorry, minus 210. What it is? VR by is 440 at an angle of 30. 440 at an angle of 30 divided by its impedance. How much it is? 53 I, or else 53 at an angle of 90. Okay. So how much we will get? So solve it. You will get it as 8.301 at an angle of 120 amperes. Okay. Remember, mention the units properly. So amperes. Okay. Next, similarly, need to find out the value of IBR. So what is IBR? Voltage across it. How much it is? VBR divided by its impedance. What is its impedance? 50 plus 40J. Okay. ZBR. I will write it as ZBR. So which is equal to 440. And what is the angle? What is the angle here? Okay. Minus 180 plus 30. Minus 210. Okay. Divided by Z 50 plus 40J. Okay. So solve it. You will get it as 6.871 at an angle of 1.34 amperes. So we have found the value of IR by and IBR. So substitute here. So 8.301 at an angle of 120 minus 6.871 at an angle of 111.34. Okay. So you will get it as 1.829 at an angle of 154.44. Okay, I will write in the new page clearly. So IR we have got as 1.29829 at an angle of 154.44 amperes, and pressure coil voltage, how much it is? VYB, how much it is? 440 at an angle of VYB, how much? Minus 90. So what will be the wattmeter reading? Wattmeter reading will be, okay, VYB IR into cos of angle. Okay, so how much it is? 440 into 1.829 into angle, cos of angle, how much it is? Okay, 154.44 plus 90, okay, angle between these two vectors. So, how much minus, okay, solve it, you will get it as 347.218 watts, okay. So, depending upon the connections, you need to find out the reading of the wattmeter. So, third question, so it is a SSCJ question, one more question, right. So, in a balanced three phase supply, the current coil of the wattmeter is connected in line 1 and the potential coil is connected between 2 and 3. So, we know, we already solved the problem in the first, this type of problem in the first question itself, right. So, consider it in a balanced system, the current coil, okay, the current coil is connected in phase A 1 and pressure coil is connected between 2 and 3. If the wattmeter is reading, so what the wattmeter will read? VL IL sin phi, okay. So, how much it is reading? 100 watts, okay. Then, what is the reactive power drawn by the three phase load? So, what it is asking, what they were asking? They were asking to find out the value of the reactive power. So, what we know? We know that to find out the reactive power in a single wattmeter method, okay, multiply root 3 with the wattmeter reading. So, if you multiply with the root 3, how much you will get it as 173.2 VAR, right? So, option D is the correct one, okay, simple question, right? So, consider the fourth question, right? In this question, what they were asking, right, a single phase load is connected between YR and Y terminals of a 415 volts symmetrical three phase supply, right. So, single phase load is connected between, see here, phase R and Y. So, what the with what source we have exerted the load with a line voltage of 415 volts, right. The wattmeter reading is connected as shown in the figure. So, where the wattmeter is connected? The wattmeter, the pressure coil, the current coil is connected in a series with the load, and the pressure coil is connected between the phase B and the neutral. The power factor of the load is given as 0.8 lagging, then wattmeter reading will be. So, what we know, the wattmeter reading will be the pressure coil voltage into current coil current into cos of the angle between VP and IC, right? VP. See here, what is the voltage across the pressure coil? This will be the phase voltage, but we need to consider the angles also properly. So, what I will write here? So, VB, okay, VB into current. What is the current? How much, what is the current flowing? Okay, I will write it as IR current into cos of angle between VB and IR. Okay, but here we need to find out the value of IR. See, IR, the current flowing through the current coil will be VRY divided by its impedance. Okay, VRY divided by its impedance. You get a, this will be my V by VR, VB. Okay, so VRY will be, so this will be my minus VY, okay. So, the summation of these two vectors will lead my VRY. So, how much I can write? I can write it as 415 at an angle of 30 divided by its impedance. What is its impedance? 100 ohms at an angle of, with 0.8 power factor, okay. So, it means how much we had given? Cos phi value they had given as 0.8, means phi equal to cos inverse of 0.8 lag, okay. So, which will be, I can write it as 36.86. So, my Z, I can write it as 100 at an angle of 36.86. So, see here, right. So, Z equal to 100 at an angle of 36.86. So, at last I will get the value of IR as 415 divided by 100, 4.15 at an angle of 30 minus 36. So, minus 6.86. So, IR will be 4.15 at an angle of minus 6.86. 86 amperes, and then VB, okay, VBN, okay. So the pressure coil is excited with a phase voltage. So it will be 415 divided by root 3, and what is its angle? It will be minus 240, or else I can write it as plus 120. So at last, wattmeter reading equal to 415 divided by root 3 into 4.15 into cos of angle. What is the angle between these two vectors? 120 plus 6.86. So if you solve it, you will get it as minus 596.46 watts. Okay. Right. So minus 597 watts. So the answer is minus 597 watts. Okay. So this is the last problem in this lecture. So let us read the problem clearly. So determine the wattmeter reading in the circuit shown in figure if the terminals A and B respectively are connected to X and Y. Second option, second question, X and Z, and third question, Y and Z. Right. So in what they were asking, so this is my current coil which is connected here, and the pressure coil terminals A and B, first they had connected to X and B they had connected to Y, and then what is the wattmeter reading? This will be question A. And question B, what they were asking, if these terminals are connected between, okay, X and Z, means A is connected to X and B is connected to Z, then what will be the wattmeter reading? And in C, if these terminals are connected at A is connected to Y and B is connected to Z, then what is the wattmeter reading they were asking. Okay, so let us redraw this circuit. So I'm redrawing this circuit as, see here, this is my AC source which is having 200 volt RMS, and then I'm having the current coil, right? Next, resistance of 10 ohms, okay. Here, see here, this 20 ohms and 10 J are connected in parallel. So first find out the equivalent impedance. Equivalent impedance. So how we are going to find out the equivalent impedance? Z equal to 20 into 10 J divided by 20 plus 10 J. So solve it. How much you are getting? Yeah. So it will be 4 plus 8 J. Okay. So I am writing it as, okay, 4 plus 8 J. Now see here. Now, at first, the pressure coil is connected between terminals X and Y, okay. So, the pressure coil is connected between the terminals X and Y, okay. This is my X and Y, alright. So, this is for question A, okay. Now solve the answer, okay. So, I can write it as wattmeter reading equal to, okay, for question A, the wattmeter reading will be equal to current coil current into pressure coil voltage into cos of angle between the two vectors, volt pressure coil voltage and current coil current. So what is the current flowing through the first find out the current IC, okay, first find out the current IC, right. Current flowing through the current coil equal to 200, its voltage divided by impedance, okay. This voltage divided by total circuit impedance. How much it will be? 200 divided by, sorry, total impedance. Total impedance. So what will be the total impedance? 4 plus 8J plus 10. So how much will be the current coil? Okay. How much it is? You will get it as the current flowing through the current coil will be equal to 12.403 at an angle of minus 29 amperes. Okay. Minus 29 amperes. Now, what is the voltage across a pressure coil? Vp. Okay. Voltage across a pressure coil equal to the current. Okay. What the load current IL. The load current IL into its resistance. Okay. So, how much it will be? You will get it as I into R resistance. So, it will be equal to 12.403 at an angle of minus 29 into 10. So 124.03 at an angle of minus 29 volts. Okay. Now what will be the wattmeter reading? See here, the wattmeter reading will be equal to current coil current 12.403 1.403 into pressure coil voltage 124.03 into cos of angle between the two vectors. What is the angle between the two vectors? Zero. So how much you will get? Okay, solve it. How much you are getting? 1537.6 watts. Right. So this is the for question A. Similarly, we'll solve for question B. Okay, we'll do one thing. We'll solve in the new page. Right. So consider again, redraw the circuit. Okay, you can redraw it as 200 volt current coil. Then I'm having it in ohm resistor. This we already redrawed. This impedance will be 4 + 8j. This will be my 10 ohms. Now, see here. Now, in question B, what they were asking? They were asking when the pressure coil terminals A and B are connected to X and Z. Okay, X and Z means how will be the my pressure coil connections now? X means here. And Z means here. Totally, they were asking what is the power delivered to that load, this complete load, how much it will be. Now, the wattmeter reading for question B, this is for question B, okay. Wattmeter reading equal to current coil. See, the current will not change. Already, we have derived the current value IL. IL current, how much we got in the last, in question A itself, we have derived how much it is? 12.4083 at an angle of minus 29. Okay, 12.403 at an angle of minus 29. Okay, minus 29. Yeah, minus 29. And what is the voltage? Okay, how much it is? Complete the source voltage itself. You are up. The pressure coil is connected between the source voltage itself. So what can you write? You can write it as 200 volts. Okay, now what will be the wattmeter reading? The wattmeter reading will be equal to pressure coil voltage 200 into current coil current 12.403 into cos of angle between the two vectors. What is the angle between the two vectors? 29.3, right? So solve it. The W2 value, you will get it as 2153 watts. Okay, 2153 watts. Okay. Understood? Here the pressure coil is connected between across the source itself. So that I'm writing it as 200. No need to again find out the voltage. And current coil current already we have derived in the question A itself. So how much it is? 12.403 at an angle of minus 29 degrees amperes. So from there I can find out the value of W2. This will be my W1. Okay. In question C, what they were asking? Okay, they were asking when the terminals are connected across at Y and B, means see here, this terminal is connected to here Y and this terminal is connected to here, okay, here by Z. Okay, then find out the value of, okay, so solve this problem by yourself and comment your answer in the comment section. Okay, I hope my lecture is clear to you. If you have any doubts, you may ask in the comment section. If you want more videos on this series, that is 5 problems on series, you may ask your topic in the comment section. If you like the video, hit the like button. See you in the next lecture. I will end here. Thank you.